I wanted to introduce tables. If you've never tried that in Excel, I wanted to show you some of the great benefits. Here I've got a data list, and you can see I've got what I would call a heading row, and I've used full words text for that heading row, which would be a good practice. And then I've got row after row of transactional data. So every row is one record of data. And you can easily sort and filter this. You've got on the Home tab down here, you can sort. I'm clicked anywhere on the date column, and I can go oldest to newest, or newest to oldest, or I could sort by any of these categories or any of these numbers. Sorting largest to smallest, and I can do like that. So I can also turn on my filtering from here too. There's a filter button, and what it does, it allows me to get these little drop-down handles, and I can quickly filter out different identifiers there, whatever categories that I want. You see, you can tell I've got a filter on because I see a filter there. And I see that my rows have turned bright blue. But anytime that you want to do those kind of activities, and again, that will just turn on and off, what I would actually go do is go to insert a table, because you're going to get more features with a table. It is picking up that I have a header row. It's picking up my entire range. I have 300 rows of stuff here, and OK. And then what you get is a Table Tools Design tab. Now this is really good, and it adds more functionality than you get with just those other things. You still are going to be able to easily sort and filter by each of these. You are also going to get things like these design items that you like it's made my header row a nice bright blue. I've got the banded rows, which is the every other row coloring format. If you've ever tried to do that manually and then changed your data, you know what a hassle that can be. And in contrast, you can also band columns if you'd rather. You can also put in a last column or a first column, making those more stand out. And it depends really on what format you've chosen. Now here you see I got a default one when I started, but I can adjust these and turn formatting off and on as I like. So I think I'll do the banded rows and then maybe add a total row, which is really cool with this. If I click that, it adds a total row at the bottom. And what it's actually doing, it's allowing me to pick my favorite functions on the bottom of each. So I could count how many records. I could do an average of the quantities. And maybe what I want to do is get a sum here for that. Oh, I need more room. Adjust that with a double click on the border there. And then probably I don't need anything here. That doesn't make much sense. Or I could average it, would be probably better. And what you see there is I am in getting totals. What makes this even nicer is then when I do some sorting and filtering, like here I'm gonna click select all and just pick Northeast. Then what you see is I am getting totals for just that filtered out group. It would take me a long time to do that manually. I hope you notice one other thing happening when I scroll down in a large list. Look, my A, B, C become actually my table heading names. It is super easy to add columns like that. I just type next door to it and it will add it. It's super easy to do calculations. So I can do equals, let's just say this times this. That's actually going to give us the tax rate, isn't it? We'll change that, call it tax. Okay. And then I can quickly also select If I click the H, I'm getting the whole column, which is like a million rows. Watch how I do this though. If I click a little lower, I'm getting just the items in my table all the way down to the bottom. And I'm going to quickly turn on the currency for that. Okay, so that's my quick introduction to tables. Hope you like it.